Hey everyone, welcome to Behind the Code. Today we're going to be talking all about the Universal Analytics Upgrade. And to do that, we're going to go right to the source. We have Nick Mihalovsky joining us in the studio. He's the product manager who's been working on the Universal Analytics Upgrade tool, working tirelessly to bring this upgrade to all of our users. So thanks for joining us, Nick.
Yeah, thanks for having me here.
Cool. Let's take a look at the agenda. So Nick's going to give us an overview of what Universal Analytics is. Second thing we'll do is we'll go through an overview of the upgrade itself. So what is it, why we're doing it, and just generally what the steps are, so you know a little bit more about that. Next, we'll cover some common questions. We've been getting a lot of questions from developers about how to use our upgrade tool, what that process looks like. Also questions about implementation and code. So we'll go through that as well, and Nick will give us some tips and great context along the way. And then at the end, we'll give you some resources that you can go to after the video. So if you have questions or want to find out more about a particular topic of the upgrade, you can check out the resources and learn more. Let's start at a super high level. For those who haven't heard of it before, what is Universal Analytics, Nick? Can you give us an overview?
Yeah, it's a great question. I mean, Universal Analytics is huge, right? It's universal.
Right.
So let me try to contain it down into something really basic.
Cool. All right.
So in the past, Google Analytics has been about tracking websites and web pages. So over the past 15 years, we've seen a huge increase in mobile content consumption, consumption across tablets, and even content being distributed across many other factors like kiosks, game consoles. Mm-hmm. And so what we saw is a need to create new infrastructure within Google Analytics that allows us to track user behavior across all of these devices. So we launched last year Universal Analytics as a set of features and libraries, as well as infrastructure, to allow us to now enable businesses to measure how users interact with their business across all these different devices.
Cool. So it's a collection, you'd say it's some infrastructure changes, it's also new reports and new features, and also new libraries, all bundled together.
Correct, all bundled together. And what really it is a platform for us to add additional functionality and features to really help users better understand how customers help them understand how users are interacting with their business across all these different environments.
Cool, okay. So let's talk about the upgrade then.
Sure.
So why are we doing an upgrade? What is it?
That's a good question. Yeah. When we launched Universal Analytics, we required users to create brand new properties or tracking units. And so all of the historical data that they had was still being processed by classic analytics, and only new properties were being processed by Universal Analytics.
Right.
So what the upgrade allows people to do is to actually upgrade their classic analytics accounts into Universal Analytics accounts. And the features are fantastic because now you have ability to get all the power of the new Universal Analytics while maintaining all your historical data. Mm-hmm. So you can still do year-over-year trends, month-over-month trends, pre and post the upgrade, but you can also take advantage of all the brand new features.
Cool. So it's going to be seamless then in reports, right?
Exactly.
Awesome. So how would one upgrade?
Well, we try to make it as simple as possible, and we boil it down into two easy steps. Mm-hmm. The first step is you actually have to transfer processing from your classic analytics to Universal Analytics, and that's done through a tool. The second step is to actually re-tag or re-implement the tracking code to go from the classic tracking library to the new Universal Analytics library.
Right.
Now, the second step is optional, but it's highly recommended.
Okay, so you don't have to change your code. But we recommend that you do.
You don't have to change it, but we recommend you do.
Okay. And maybe we'll talk a little bit more about that later when we talk more about implementation of code. Cool. Now, one other thing that I wanted to ask you, because I've gotten a bunch of questions on this, is there anybody who shouldn't be upgrading right now? Because a lot of people watching this might have the question, should I upgrade or should I wait? Or is there anything people should know?
It's a great question. So today, there's many features in Google Analytics. The double-click integration features that deal with remarketing, double-click for advertisers, these features, the features that uses the DCJS tracking code,
mm-hmm.
these features we're still working on to support them in Universal Analytics.
Okay.
So if you are using any of these features, you should wait just a little bit longer till we have full support for all the features.
Cool.
So if you're using those, you shouldn't use the upgrade today. The other set of users who shouldn't do this upgrade is if you're not familiar with how you've implemented the tracking code, make sure you go to somebody who is more familiar and make sure that there's no issues with your implementation that will break. So you want to make sure you go through all of the, you spend the time learning about what this upgrade is and the implications it could have. Mm-hmm. Again, you know, there's many people using Google Analytics, and a lot of them use it in very creative ways. And so if you are using it in a creative way, you want to make sure that you know all the caveats involved to make sure that your upgrade is as seamless as possible and there's no risk of data quality issues.
Sure. So for example, if you did like a really custom implementation with GAJS on your website,
correct,
you're definitely one of the people who we would suggest would spend a little bit more time up front to figure out if anything's going to break when you update.
Absolutely.
Code. Yeah. Cool. So let's talk about the upgrade tool. Because you mentioned there were two steps, right? You're going to transfer your property using a tool, and then you can optionally update the code.
Yep.
So this would be step one, using the upgrade tool.
Correct.
Cool. What is the upgrade tool? What do you do?
Right. Well, the upgrade tool starts with that admin UI in Google Analytics.
OK. I think I have a screenshot, so let me show it, and then you can give us a description.
Yeah, fantastic. So the upgrade tool allows you to come into the admin UI. There's a new section for upgrading, Universal Analytics upgrade, under each property. So this happens at the property level. So if you look at the property column, you'll see a new tab for the upgrade. And when you click on that, you'll actually be able to go and get to a page that takes you through a series of steps to transfer processing from Classic to Universal Analytics. Okay. So what you do is you come into the tool, you accept it, you look through the information, read all the documentation. When you're ready, you click to the next stage. You get a dialogue sharing kind of all the little caveats and details. Mm-hmm. And once you've agreed and you confirm, we actually schedule your property to be transferred. Now, the transfer actually takes between 24 and 48 hours. Okay. And so you can actually come back. You'll see a little state change that says transfer in progress. And actually, under the tab for Universal Analytics upgrade, it'll say transfer in progress.
Right.
So you can always revisit to see where you are, what stage you're at. Once we've finally transferred after that time, then it'll be saying transfer complete. And so that means once the transfer is done, you've completed step one of the upgrade process.
Okay, so that's, I click the transfer button, I'm gonna wait 24 to 48 hours, check my account, and it's gonna give me a notice that says it's done, right?
It's that easy.
That easy, cool. So during that time, can I still send data?
You can continue to send data,
yeah.
But during the time, you should not re-tag to the new tracking code.
Right.
You need to make sure that you complete step one, which is the transfer of processing, before you move to step two, which is actually re-implementation of tracking code.
Otherwise?
If you don't do that, there could lead to data quality issues.
Okay. So transfer, wait until we confirm it's been done in your account, and then you can change your code if you want to.
Exactly.
Step two. Cool. So I've gotten this question from a number of users who don't actually see the upgrade tool in their account. Is there any reason why someone out there today would not see the upgrade tool?
Yeah.
And how do they get to see it, I guess?
It's great. So we whitelisted or enabled this upgrade tool for pretty much all of the different accounts and the properties within. The only properties and accounts we haven't enabled it for is for properties or profiles that are using any of our double-click integration features. For example, remarketing or double-click for advertisers. If anybody's enabled these features, we've explicitly not enabled this tool for any of the profiles within their account. And the reason why is that we want to be extra careful because we don't have full feature support for these features in Universal Analytics. We're still working on them.
Like remarketing,
exactly.
Double-click stuff.
Yeah. Right, because we don't have the full feature support for that. We don't want to have somebody accidentally upgrade their account to something that they can't use.
Right, okay.
So for those properties, if you don't see this today, don't worry. We're just ensuring that there will be no issues when we actually do enable it for them.
Got it. Yeah. And for accounts that have a lot of users, how do you know if somebody else may have already upgraded your property?
What you can do is always come into the property column, mm-hmm. and you'll look at the upgrade Universal Analytics upgrade tab, and you'll always get the status of where you are, whether it's transfers in progress, or if it hasn't been done, or if it's complete.
Okay, cool. So it's in the admin section. Look at the property
column,
Universal Analytics upgrade tab. Great. So now let's talk about step two of the upgrade process, which is actually updating your code. So you mentioned that updating the code is actually optional, right? Step one, transfer your property, but step two is optional.
Right.
Why wouldn't you update your code, or what do you get from updating your code?
Right. So that when in Universal Analytics, when we launched that, we also announced a new tracking code that works with Universal Analytics, mm-hmm. Analytics.js.
This for web.
For web, yes. And so the Analytics.js library is a lot more flexible for developers. So if you are customizing the code, it's a lot easier to customize, and there's a lot more functionality built to simplify the customization. Mm-hmm. So customization is a big thing. The second part of it is for large websites. For example, with the new tracking code, we only use one cookie. The old tracking code, we use 5 cookies. Mm-hmm. So because cookies are sent with all the different requests on the page, you actually can reduce a significant amount of bandwidth for large sites as well.
Cool. Yeah.
And finally, I think the most important reason is that we have a bunch of new features we're working on with mm-hmm. Universal Analytics. We've announced some like user ID. These type of features will only work with the new tracking code. And increasingly, we've kind of have a team mandate that all new features are built only using Universal Analytics. Right. So increasingly, we can't talk about them here, but we are working on many new features that will only be supported by what we're by the new Analytics.js tracking library.
Right. So if you want access to the latest and greatest stuff, use Analytics.js and upgrade your
right.
code. Right. So what can you give us like just an overview of the changes that you would need to make as a developer if you kind of had a simple site and a simple implementation of GA.js, what would you need to do to get to Analytics.js?
Well, the basic implementation for Google Analytics on a website is to put a piece of JavaScript on all the pages of your site. Mm-hmm. So that piece of JavaScript has changed with Analytics.js.
Okay.
So at minimum, you'd have to go through all the different pages of your site and implement the new tracking code.
Okay.
Replace the old one with the new. Now, for people who are doing more sophisticated integrations, they have event tracking, social interactions, e-commerce. The actual tracking interface, the actual methods that you use on the tracking code mm-hmm. have changed. So what you'll need to do is update all the places where you're calling the old library with the new methods that are corresponding to the new library.
Got it. So for some people with big sites, this is actually a pretty sizable amount of work, right?
Yeah.
Do they need to update everything all at once? I mean, could you have on a page some old GA.js code and some new Analytics.js code?
Well, that's a great question. And so we've designed these libraries to work together, but there are some caveats. So for a given page, the tracking works at a property ID, or a property ID. So this UA number, UA XXX hyphen Y.
Right.
And so for one of those properties, you can only use one tracking mechanism on a given page. So either using Analytics.js or GA.js.
Okay.
For a given page. Now, across different pages, we have made these libraries work together. So you can have the old tracking GA.js code on 50% of pages for one property.
Okay.
And for the other 50%, you could have the new one, Analytics.js, for the same property.
Okay.
So the problem really arises when you actually, for the same property on the same page, use different libraries.
So for those people who are planning on retagging, you could plan to kind of break it up into chunks. I'm going to retag 25% of my pages with
exactly.
Analytics.js and so
right.
forth and so on. The problem comes when you try to get down on the page level and say, some of this stuff is going to be Analytics.js on this page, the rest is GA.js. That's
correct.
Not good.
Right,
don't
exactly,
that.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's for a given property. Now, of course, there's always the sophisticated users
right.
who are using multiple properties on the same page, right, for roll-up reporting or something
mm-hmm.
like this.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have multiple properties on the same page, you can use GA.js for one of the properties and Analytics.js for the other property.
Mm-hmm.
The problem arises when it's the same property on the same page with two different tracking
codes. Got it. Is there any reason to dual tag at this point? I mean, we have the upgrade tool, so is there any reason that you would want to dual tag your site completely with the old code and the new code, or is it just time to switch over completely?
So dual tagging, what a lot of people do is they'll have the old legacy GA.js across their site,
mm-hmm.
and then they'll create a new Universal Analytics property, and then they'll implement Analytics.js with the new one across their site. So you're tagging with two properties
right.
because we didn't have this upgrade tool in the past.
Right.
Now, when people compare the data between the two, they're always going to see a difference because the actual sequence of when the actual requests are sent, the hits are sent to Google Analytics
mm-hmm.
differ.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll always never see a difference. So what we recommend for all users, now we have the upgrade, is to actually go through the upgrade. Don't dual tag. Don't create a new Universal Analytics property.
Okay.
Rather, convert your existing one to Universal Analytics, and that ensures that the data is most consistent, you have the historical data, and then make sure that you don't have these kind of deltas between the two tracking codes because they're firing at a different rate in the browser.
Right. Okay, that makes sense. What happens for those people who are going to put this off, which I don't hold it against them
for
putting it off, what happens if they do nothing right now? So you have GA.js on your website, it's been working fine. Let's say you transfer your property over, but you don't actually upgrade your code.
Right.
What happens then?
So once you've transferred to Universal Analytics, mm-hmm. you can still send the data from the old tracking library. That will continue to work. Over time, you'll see that more features are added to the Analytics.js library, so you won't get to take advantage of them. But we'll still collect the old data and process that.
Okay.
And we can look a little bit into the timeline, kind of talk about like how this will work out in the long term.
Okay, cool. Let's move. So we just talked about websites and code and implementation issues there. Let's move to mobile apps.
Sure.
So if I think the users out there who are using SDK version 1, that's really the library that we're talking about. Those are the people who are going to be upgrading, because version 2 or higher are already sending hits to Universal Analytics. So for those users using version 1, what does the upgrade process look like for them? Is it kind of the same thing as web?
It's similar, but it's different. So it's important for mobile users to pay attention.
Yeah.
Step 1 of transferring from Classic to Universal Analytics continues to work. When you do the transfer, you might see some small differences in the way the sessions are calculated. Mm-hmm. You might have a lower number of visits to the site, but there's no way around this. This is just the way that we're changing on how sessions are calculated between the old Classic and into the new Universal Analytics.
Okay.
So you might see a slight decrease in the number of visits in your reporting profile. And that's for transferring on step one. Once you've completed step one, you'll continue to actually view your data in Google Analytics as a web profile. Now, when we introduced app tracking last year, we introduced a brand new data model, new app tracking Google Analytics. It was actually really based on Universal Analytics.
Right.
But it also came with a new app tracking data model. That was all around screen views and metrics that made sense for applications.
Right.
We also created a whole new set of UI reports specific to apps. Now, those work with SDK 2 plus versions, mm-hmm. but they don't work with V1 that's still using the old page view tracking.
Right.
So if you are using V1, you have a couple options. One is to continue using the V1 SDK and viewing your reports in web profiles, mm-hmm. as a standard web profile. The second option you have is you can actually upgrade to V2, change all your code from page tracking to app tracking. Okay. But today, if you view that in Analytics, you'll actually have to create a new app profile. Mm-hmm. And all your data will be in the app profile.
Right.
So the issue it becomes is that now all the new data is in an app profile, whereas all the old data is in a web profile.
Right.
And so the challenge with that is that you actually can't trend data over time because they're in different profiles.
Got it.
So it leads to some reporting challenges.
Got it. So if you want continuity between the data, you would complete step one, transfer your property.
Yep.
Don't upgrade your code. Still use SDK V1 and keep sending your hits there. And that will work fine, and everything will be continuous, just like you'd expect.
Correct.
If you wanted to get access to the new reporting features for apps, all the new stuff that we've launched for apps, you'd actually have to create a new app profile or a new app view.
Right.
And then upgrade your code and send your data to that.
Right.
And that causes the break in continuity.
Correct.
OK, so it's a bit of a trade-off.
It's a bit of a trade-off right now.
Right.
This is something that we're working on. So by all means, like, there's no rush to actually re-tag to version 2.
Mm-hmm.
But we do recommend at least looking at step 1 to transfer from Classic to Universal Analytics processing.
Right. So step 1, everybody can do it.
Everybody can do that today. Yeah. It's the re-tagging where there's a couple considerations.
Got it. Cool. Great. So we've covered step one and step two of the upgrade process. I definitely wanted to ask you more about the timeline, because I'm sure people are going to be wondering when they need to actually do this stuff and what we're doing on our end as well. Can you speak to, so we got four phases in this timeline. This is actually unique because we published our timeline.
Right. Usually we never publish timelines. So this is something
It's pretty
excited that we try to be as transparent as possible.
So we got four phases. We're in the first phase, right?
Correct.
Can you walk us through where we are right now and where we're going?
Right. So phase one was really the launch and announcement that we can actually do this upgrade. Our goal at the end of the day is to transfer 100% of properties from Classic to Universal Analytics, as well as get everybody to upgrade and to start only building features on Universal Analytics. Mm-hmm. So we announced the upgrade so people can migrate from the Classic to Universal Analytics a couple months ago. So that's where we are. Phase two is that we realize many people won't actually go through the step one transferring. So what we plan to do is to start auto transferring properties from Classic to Universal Analytics. So what that means is instead of the end users going into the interface and admin tool and transferring, we'll manually go in and set that bit for them. And then over time, their stuff will be transferred on the processing side.
So when does that happen?
So we've started with some test accounts, and that will start ramping up probably within the next month or so to start with small accounts, accounts that have much lower risk of having data quality issues. And then over time, as we get full feature parity, we'll then start ramping that up to account the larger accounts, accounts with integrations with AdSense, AdWords, the double click, and finally, the premium clients will be last in that.
Got it.
Now, phase three is once we have full feature support. So again, we're missing some double click features. Today, Universal Analytics is still in beta, and it doesn't have some of the premium SLAs. So our goal is to have one large announcement that actually takes Universal Analytics out of beta, has 100% feature support, full SLA, and the goal is to do that early next year. And so once we do that phase three, we'll be ramping up this auto transferring of properties much more. We'll be doing more at a time. And our final goal, or final end goal, once we've reached 100% of properties transferred to Universal Analytics, is to then enter phase four, which Universal Analytics becomes the default of Google Analytics. They become the same thing. At that point, we will actually announce the deprecation of the old tracking code, GAJS, as well as some of the custom variables.
Got it.
And so the announcement of the deprecation really means we'll continue to accept and process the data, but we'll do so for a minimum of 2 years.
Okay.
So after 2 years, you know, we'll revisit whether we want to continue doing that or we want to make sure that everybody upgrades to the new tracking code.
Got it. Okay. So auto-transferring, nobody's going to be auto-transferred who is using a feature that we don't yet support, right?
Correct.
We're waiting until we have support, and then we'll start moving those accounts.
Right. A lot of people had concern about that. And we want to make, we're completely taking that into account. We're being very cautious on who we transfer. And only once we have full feature support and everything works well, will we then start enabling it for, you know, doing it more broadly.
Got it. And it sounds like from what you were saying, after, when we get to phase four and we announce the deprecation of GAJS, there's going to be a minimum 2 years.
Correct.
Where you're good. So from today, you've got 2 years plus of using GAJS.
Of using GAJS.
And yeah, we'll support it.
We'll continue to support it.
Okay. Cool.
There is kind of a nuance there. Some of the more power users are using a feature called custom variables. Custom variables was available in GAJS. In Analytics.js, we have something new called custom dimensions.
Right.
And there is really no migration between the two. That being said, if you are sending custom variables and you do transfer processing to Universal Analytics, we'll continue to process the custom variables in Universal Analytics as a legacy feature.
Got it. But you wouldn't get access to custom dimensions unless you upgraded your code.
Unless you upgraded the code.
Got it. Cool. Well, we've covered step one and two of the upgrade, as well as the timeline. I just wanted to quick give everyone some resources that you can go to after watching this video. So if you want to learn more about how to upgrade, we have this whole upgrade center that we've published. It's at developers.google.com/analytics/upgrade. You can go there, and it covers migration paths for whatever library you're using. We've documented how to upgrade from there. So definitely check that out. If you have any other questions on top of that, we have a UA upgrade forum that you can check out, and the link is here on this slide. And as I mentioned at the beginning, we're also going to be doing a follow-up Q&A session. So if you have any questions that we didn't cover today, and I'm sure there are a bunch out there, definitely post your questions to our Google moderator. And we should have a link to that below this video. So definitely do that, and we'll be back in about a month, give or take, and we'll answer those questions and hopefully some more as well. So cool, thanks for joining us. This has been Behind the Code, all about the Universal Analytics upgrade. Check us out on G+ as well. Feel free, as I said, to check out our Upgrade Center as well if you want to learn more. We'll catch you next time.